Hello and welcome to another episode in the Godot Basics tutorial series. In this episode, we will be taking a look at the Audio Stream Player class. Now, when it comes to 2D, there are two different types of Audio Stream Players. There's the original, which is called Audio Stream Player, which plays audio non-positionally, and there is Audio Stream Player 2D. And the Audio Stream Player 2D plays audio that dampens with the distance from the screen center based on the position of your Audio Stream Player 2D node. One thing to keep in mind is that the Audio Stream Player class inherits from the Node class, and the Audio Stream Player 2D class inherits from Node 2D. What this means is that your Audio Stream Player 2D node has transform properties, and that would include position. However, one thing to keep in mind is that both the Audio Stream Player class and the Audio Stream Player 2D class have the life cycle scripts available to them. Now, the Audio Stream Player and the Audio Stream Player 2D class come with similar properties and methods. So let's go ahead and take a look at the ones you'll need in order to play your music. Let's start with the properties. First, you have the autoplay property, and just like the name implies, when the autoplay property is set to true, your music will play when the Audio Stream Player has been loaded onto the scene tree. On top of that, you also have a bus property, which lets you know where you'd like your music, or excuse me, sounds to be connected to. The third property is the stream property, which is just basically an audio stream data type, which is just your music file. The fourth property is stream paused, and just like the name implies, it will pause the playing of your audio. And lastly, you do have the property called volume DB, which is a float data type, and all that does is it increases or decreases the sound output of your audio. Now, out of all these properties, the most important property to understand will be the stream property, which again is basically your audio file. So let's go ahead and take a look at that. So the Audio Stream class is the base class for audio streams, and it only comes with one method, no properties, and that method is called getLength, and all that returns back to you is a float value, which will be the total length of your audio file in seconds. The Audio Stream class does have children, 5 to be exact, and those are the Audio Stream Sample class, which handles WAV files, the Audio Stream OGG Vorbis class, which handles OGG files, which is similar to MP3s. Basically, this audio file type is compressed. The third child class is Audio Stream Generator, which allows you to manually generate your own sounds. The fourth class is Audio Stream Random Pitch, which changes the pitch of your music randomly on every playthrough. And lastly is the Audio Stream Microphone class, which is just for recording if your computer or device supports microphones. Now, moving back into the Audio Stream Player class, we do have 5 methods, and that is the Get Playback Position, which is where you are in your music file currently. You have the Get Stream Playback, which returns back an Audio Stream Playback data type. You have the Play method, which takes in one optional argument, which just means that you're going to play your audio file at the position you pass in, and if you do not pass in a position, then you'll just start at the beginning. The fourth method is called seek, and it takes in one argument, which is that it will set its playback position to the argument you pass in. The difference between the play method and the seek method is that the play method, on top of starting on the position you pass in to the argument, you will go ahead and play that music for your user, whereas the seek method will just move the playback position to whatever the argument value is, and it will not play the music to the user. And the last method is the stop method, which just stops your audio file from playing. And on top of that, the Audio Stream Player comes with one signal called finished. When your song or audio file finishes playing, it will emit the finished signal. We will not go over signals in this episode. Now, let's go ahead and take a look at some code. Over here in the Scene Tree tab, you'll notice we have a root node called Node2D and a child node called Audio Stream Player. And notice it's missing something. It's missing the animation player, and that's because we don't need the animation player to play music. We can actually skip the animation player class and go directly into the AudioStream Player class in order to play our music with and without code. So let's go ahead and take a look at how to play music through code first. So over here, I have a script attached to it called audioscript.gd. Notice here that it extends from AudioStream Player. We have the ready virtual method, and we declare a variable called AudioStream. The data type is AudioStream, and we're going to load our simple melody wave file inside our variable called AudioStream. We're going to take this variable and we're going to pass it into our stream property using the setStreamSetter method. And notice we use the self keyword because we are extending from AudioStream Player. So we have access to the methods and properties of the AudioStream Player class that we saw in the slideshows. Now, on top of setting our stream, now that we have a music file to play, we can set the volume. I'm going to set it to 3 decibels. So hopefully not too loud, but loud enough to hear the music play. Last but not least, we are going to use the play method. We take in no arguments. So that means we're going to start at the beginning and we're going to play our audio file. Let me go ahead and add the self keyword. So as you can see, using the AudioStream Player is fairly straightforward, but we can do more. We won't go over in this episode, but I just want to show you regardless. So in this case, we have a variable called AudioStream and it's a data type AudioStream. And we are preloading our simple melody.wav file. Well, we know we are preloading a WAV file. So instead of using AudioStream, we can use the child class called AudioStreamSample. Now, when we inherit from the AudioStreamSample, not only do we have that one function called getLink from the AudioStream class, we also get functions and properties available to us in the AudioStreamSample. And that includes things like looping, where to start, where to end, the loop mode, and so forth. And so as you can see here through code, we can do quite a lot of things with our audio file, depending on the audio file we are loading. Now, if I go ahead and press play, you're going to hear the music. And that's basically it when it comes to using code to play music using the AudioStream Player node. Now, let me go ahead and detach the script, and let's go ahead and see how we can use the AudioStream Player node to play music without code. To elaborate, the AudioStream Player comes with a few properties, the most important property being the stream property, which takes in an AudioStream data type. If we go ahead and click the drop-down menu, you're going to see the 5 choices. The 2 that deals with music will be AudioStreamSample and AudioStreamOGGVorbis. Because the music is a WAV file, it will be the AudioStreamSample we need to use. So if I go ahead and click it, you're going to see it pops up, different options, different formats, looping options if we want it in stereo. We can go ahead and click it to replace it, and we'll see that it automatically updates to fit our music. As you can see here, the 8-bit changed to 16, our mix rate changed to 48,000. And this is basically all the options we have when dealing with the AudioStreamSample class. Let me go ahead and exit out. The AudioStream Player comes with a few other properties. The 2 properties you may find useful if wanting to play music without code will be autoplay. If you set this to true and you press the play button for the scene that this AudioStream Player node is attached to, when the scene loads, you're going to play the music. However, the coolest thing is the playing property. By default, it's set to false. You have to use the play method to set this to true. However, without actually playing the game, if you go ahead and checkmark this button, the music will play. And that's pretty cool. It allows us to debug our music. Or rather, it gives us one way of quickly debugging our music without actually running our game. Another property you may find useful, especially if you are well-versed in audio engineering, is the bus property. And by default, we are set to master. However, we are able to edit and customize our audio buses, but we won't look into that in this episode. We will cover that in the next episode. Now, moving back to the stream property, I'm going to go ahead and clear this. Now, new audio stream OGG Vorbis requires that you have a .ogg file. The new audio stream generator requires you to basically use code to create your own music. The microphone requires you to have a microphone. The one I do want to go over with you is the random pitch. Or excuse me, the audio stream random pitch class. Now notice here our stream data type property is the audio stream random pitch class, and it offers us two different properties, audio stream and random pitch. And so I want you to imagine you have a game like Doki Doki Literature Club, and you have this happy upbeat music like My Simple Melody. But at some point you may want to change the pitch. Well, by using the random pitch audio stream class, or excuse me, the audio stream random pitch class, all you have to do is drag and drop your audio stream into your audio stream property. Now let's discuss about random pitch real quick. The lower the number, the closer it is to sounding like the original file. The larger the number, the more extreme it sounds when it plays. I'm just going to leave it to the default value 1.1, and it's going to give it an eerie sound, sort of like Doki Doki Literature Club. And so when I go ahead and play this audio stream player node, it's going to sound off. And there it is. You can hear that it does not sound like the original melody, sounds kind of eerie. Perhaps you can find a use for the audio stream random pitch class for your future games. Well, that's all I have for you in this episode. Thank you so much for joining me. Thank you for clicking the like button, and thank you for clicking the subscribe button. I'm going to go ahead and upload everything we went through onto GitHub, so please feel free to download the GitHub project and play around with the code. Anyway, I look forward to seeing you in the next episode. Have an amazing day.